Hello everybody, thank you for watching to a new episode of How to DIY to the Eachine E58 antenna mod, so we can boost the range even further from the drone this time. After already we have improved range with doing the dipole antenna upgrade to the transmitter, then we had the wifi FPV antenna mod to extend the range from the wifi FPV. Then we tried the dipole antenna on top of the drone to extend the range of the drone itself, but it failed two times because it was just too heavy and it couldn't trim out the drone so it fly really good. So now we come up with a different antenna mode to improve this antenna so we get more range by using this lighter weight antennas. So we have two different 2.4 GHz antenna here that should give us more range. This one is a little bit heavy but got a little metal piece inside there for a better signal reception. This one is super light, comes from a micro receiver, from the Flyscan micro receiver, and it's yeah, super light. The nice thing about this is that it will be standing up more easily, so it doesn't get caught with a bit of props. Standing with this heavy top, it flex around and there's a lot more chance that it hits a prop. Of course, we can use a standoff, just like a tie rack, to bind it to the tie rack with some heat shrink, so to keep it up, but there's always a chance that it will hit the prop. And the way that this antennas are way better than the original antennas, because the original antenna is just a single wire that runs to a positive, and this 2.4 GHz antennas run both ways. They got a positive wire running in the inside and then they got a negative wire running on the outside, and that's how they improve the signal reception. And the first step is going to disassemble the drone. If you didn't know how to disassemble the E58, then check out the link up top over here that we have done a completely video about how to disassemble the drone. So we get to the flight controller. So really quick, we have disassembled the Eachine E58, and here you can see that the antenna is coming into the circuit board. Then below the circuit board, you will see that this is the antenna. This is where the positive wire is going from our new antenna, and then the outside wires is going to the ground. It's sitting right next to it. So you grab your new 2.4 GHz antenna and then you cut it off right at the apex connector. Then we're gonna strip the wire for about a centimeter. And when you remove the first protection layer, you'll be finding some metal wire strings. Those are the negative strings that we're going to solder to the ground. And then on the inside, you're gonna just pull them away a little bit. And when you pull those outside wires away, you get the inner wire and there's the positive wire. Now you have to clear that up and strip it just a tiny little bit so we can solder that to where the original antenna is sitting now on the drone. It was a handsome figgly job, but we made it, so we did it off camera. At the same time, we also bundled all the negative wires together. So it's time to pre-tin it, and the same for the flight controller. Now that we have pre-tinned the flight controller and the antenna, it's time to solder them together. And the inner wire, the positive wire, is going where the antenna used to be sitting, and the outside wires are going to the ground. I pulled the antenna a little bit away from the circuit board so this negative wire is not going to arc with anything of the pad on the circuit board. And then we're going to add some hot glue to stiffen up the solder joint and preventing from anything from arcing. At the same time, you are pulling up the antenna and doing an extra dot of hot glue so it will be sticking up outside the drone. And this is then how your finished product should look like, with your flight controller with a new antenna soldered onto it to the negative and the positive, and then reinforced with some hot glue so it's nice and stiff and sticking up straight on top. Now we only have to make a little bit of hole to let the antenna stick out, and let's do it in the middle so we have the maximum space in between the motors. And we used a 5mm drill bit to drill the hole, and does it fit? Let's test. Oh, perfect, perfect, nice. Good, now we can assemble the E58, and the Eachine E58 is completely assembled again. Now it's really time to test the range, because it's gonna be a huge improvement, I can guarantee you that. But that will be coming up in the next video, so I really hope that if you're new to this channel that you subscribe for that and click the notification bell so you will be notified when that video will be released. And I want to really thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.